Hello my dear students, in the last video we studied about the classification of animals. We studied how the animals are classified according to the five features are there. So we studied in detail about how the animals are classified according to the diet and the habitat. And today we are going to study about the remaining three, that is how animals are classified according to the hours of activity, the body temperature, the presence and the absence of backbone present in the body. According to the body temperature, they are classified into two types. What are they? They are cold-blooded animals and the warm-blooded animals. So what happens in the cold-blooded animals? In the cold-blooded animals, they are not able to regulate the body temperature according to the surroundings. So what do? They change according to the surrounding. So they change. When the temperature is hot, the body also becomes hot. And when the temperature becomes cool, the body also becomes cool. So what happens here? These animals take on the temperature of the surroundings. They cannot regulate their own body temperature. They are hot when the surroundings are hot and cold when the surroundings are cold. I told you the same thing. So what happens? It can be seen in the reptiles. Reptiles means the crocodiles, alligator, lizard. These are the cold-blooded animals. And also the amphibians. Amphibians include the frog, the toad, and the fishes. All the types of fishes, they are the cold-blooded animals because they change with the help of this. They change according to the surrounding. They don't regulate the body temperature. But in case of the warm-blooded animals, what happens? Human beings are the warm-blooded animals. So what happens in the warm-blooded animals? During the summer, what do? In order to make ourselves cool, so we sweat and make ourselves cool because it is very hot outside. And in case of the cold season, that is the winter season, what do? We cover ourselves with the warm clothes and all so that we make itself warm, but we don't change according to the temperature of the surroundings. So this happens in the warm-blooded animals. So these animals are able to maintain a constant body temperature. They maintain a constant body temperature by producing heat when they are in a cold surrounding, cooling themselves when they are in warm places. So they cool themselves when they are in warm places by producing sweat or by panting. They cool themselves. In warm surroundings, some warm-blooded animals sweat or pant and they lose the heat and stay cool. So in the process of sweating, what do? They lose the heat and make themselves cool. So this happens in the humans, the apes, the monkeys, the beavers and the raccoons. So they make themselves warm by sweating. And to adapt the cool surroundings, they have the hair, the fur present in the body so that they will make themselves cool. We also have hair present in our body because we are the apes. Yes, we are the human beings. So we also have the hair on our body, but the hair on the body is very small amount as compared to animals. You might have seen the polar bear. They have full fur around the body so that they can make themselves warm in the cold weather. But some animals, they have blubber, and the blubber is seen generally in the whales. And these are the thick. These are very thick skin so as to make themselves warm during the cold season. Now we will move on to the next classification of animals, the classification based on the hours of activity. What do you mean by hours of activity? Hours of activity means that at what time during the day, night or dusk or dawn they are active. We are generally active during the daytime and we generally sleep during the night time. So generally most of the animals do so. But there are other animals who are active during the night time. You might have seen the owl, the bats. They are generally active during the night time. And they are some other animals. Some other animals are there who are generally active during the dusk and dawn. Generally during the cooler hours, and these are some other type of animals. So on the basis of this, it is classified into diurnal animals, nocturnal animals and crepuscular animals. So diurnal animals are those who are active during the day and inactive at the night. For example, that we are human beings and other mammals. Other mammals include all the animals, just like lion, tiger, all the animals and mostly the birds. They are active during the daytime and they become inactive during the night time. But the nocturnal animals are those who sleep during the day and enhance night vision. They have very good night vision and they are active during the night time. You might have seen the bats, the owl, they generally are awake during the night time. So these are called the nocturnal animals. Next is the crepuscular animals. These are the animals who hunt and stay awake during the cooler hours of the day. What are the cooler hours? The dusk and the dawn are the generally the cooler hours of the day. And these animals include the mink, the rabbit, the squirrel and the cats. They are very awake during the cooler hours of the day. Generally during the dawn and the dusk time they are awake. So these are the crepuscular animals. Now the fifth one is the animals that are classified on the basis of the presence and the absence of the backbone. If the backbone is present or the vertebral column is present in an animal, it is called the vertebrates, and if the backbone is absent, it is called the invertebrates. So generally the human beings, when you touch on the backside, you might be finding a long bone that goes at the back of the body, and with the help of this bone you are able to stand straight and you are able to bend also. This is called the vertebral column or the backbone. Animals with the backbone are called the vertebrates. They have internal skeletal system made up of bones. So we have our body is made up of totally of bones, and we have around 206 bones present in our body, and the bones is covered with the muscles, and after that we are generally the outer covering is the skin. So we generally breathe in with the help of lungs, but animals like the fishes breathe with the help of gills. We move with the help of the legs, but fishes move with the help of the fins, but fishes are also the vertebrates. Also have heads with the brain. We also have heads with the brain, and the brain forms the part of the nervous system, and brain forms the part of the nervous system. So we also have the sense organ present. So the vertebrates include the monkeys, the humans, the amphibians, reptiles, birds and the fishes. They have the backbone present and hence they are called the vertebrates. But invertebrates don't have the backbone present in the body and they are without backbone, like the spider, the insects, all the insects, the worms, the spiders, the snails, they don't have the backbone present and hence they are called the invertebrates. So today we studied about the classification of animals, and then we classified animals according to the five features, that is diet, habitat, hours of activity, the presence and the absence of backbone, and whether they are warm-blooded or they are cold-blooded. Thank you.